Hi, boys and girls. Today's December 27th, 2020, and we're going to celebrate the Holy Family of Jesus, Mary, and Joseph. Let's begin. Loving God, families come in all shapes and sizes. While no two families are alike, all are called to holiness. And our own families help us to live together in joy and peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. All right, everybody, let's sit down and get ready. Christopher's going to do the first reading, and the first reading today. Does anyone know what the fourth commandment is? We know there's 10 commandments, but today we're going to talk specifically about the fourth commandment. The fourth commandment is honor your father and mother. In today's reading, we learn what happens to people who keep this commandment.
A reading from the book of Sirach. Children, the Lord expects you to honor your father and has given your mother authority over you. If you honor your father, your sins will be forgiven. If you praise your mother, treasure will be stored up in heaven for you. If you honor your father, your own children will make you happy, and all your prayers will be answered. If you respect your father, you will live a long life. And if you listen to the Lord, your mother can relax. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Okay, now we're going to hear the responsorial psalm. Let's get ready to sing. Of the children's liturgy. Get those snappers ready. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. May the peace of Christ rule in your hearts and the fullness of his message live within you. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. In today's gospel, it's going to take place in three different lands: Judea, Egypt, and Galilee. So, Judea was the place where Jesus was born under that big star at night. Egypt was the land of pyramids where Jesus spent time as a baby. And finally, Galilee was the land where Jesus grew up and where Joseph had his carpenter stop. So let's listen to the story and see what happens in these three lands. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. A reading from the Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. An angel from the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream. The angel said, "Get up, hurry, and take the child and his mother to Egypt. Stay there until I tell you to return, because Herod is looking for the child and wants to kill him." That night, Joseph got up and took his wife and the child to Egypt, where they stayed until Herod died. So the Lord's promise came true, just as the prophet had said, "I called my son out of Egypt."
After King Herod died, an angel from the Lord appeared in a dream to Joseph while he was still in Egypt. The angel said, "Get up and take the child and his mother back to Israel. The people who wanted to kill him are now dead." Joseph got up and left with them for Israel. But when he heard that Herod's son Archaeus was now ruler of Judea, he was afraid to go there. Then, in a dream, he was told to go to Galilee, and they went there to live in the town of Nazareth. So the Lord's promise came true, just as the prophet had said, "He will be called a Nazarene." The Gospel of the Lord.
So we just heard the story about the Holy Family. Who's in the Holy Family? We have Joseph, who's the father, Mary, who's the mother, and we have baby Jesus, who was just born a couple days ago. So we have three people in that family. Now, every family looks different. Some people's family has a lot more kids. Some people's families just have pets. Some families have grandparents living with them, or aunts or uncles, or maybe cousins. But all families are different, but they're all considered families. In today's reading, God shows us that there are several ways to love each other. In the first reading that Christopher read, he told us we have to honor our father and our mother, and they love us and take care of us. Now, every person has special people in their life that are their family that we just mentioned. And those people who are special to you, you need to honor and respect. So most days we see other people. So maybe you see them on Zoom for school, or maybe you're in school part-time and you see them in the classroom. Or maybe you see people in your neighborhood when you're out playing. Now, those aren't our family members, but those people are considered our brothers and sisters. So how should we treat them? We should treat them with respect and care also. And that's what God was telling us in the first reading. So now, this brings us to Jesus telling us that we should love one another and wants us to be good to each other. But there are people that are difficult to love, and we still need to show them that. So how can we show people that are not the easiest that we love them? Well, we can try to be extra kind to them, or still try to go out our way to do nice things for them. But we have to love everybody as if they were family and put the effort in. So now, Saint Joseph, who was the father that we just heard about in the gospel, he is baby Jesus's protector, and he was told by the angel that Jesus was in a lot of danger and they needed to leave immediately. So what he did is he took Mary and Jesus to a safe place. And when he heard that Herod had died and he was told that he could move again, that's what he did. So we're told that we need to take care of each other and we need to love each other. And we show that to all people in our lives. So our grandparents, our aunts and uncles, our neighbors, our friends. And we do that by acts of kindness. Sometimes they can just be helping bring in groceries or letting your sibling play with your toy. But we have to show that. Or calling your grandparents out of the blue, or FaceTiming with them because you haven't seen them in person in a long time. Or maybe writing an email or a text to somebody saying, you know, thinking of you and can't wait to play again in the snow. So there's also people that aren't exactly in our lives, like maybe a neighbor, and you can help them by taking in a garbage can or saying to your parents, can we go help them shovel? Or maybe you baked cookies with your mom or your dad and you bring them over a couple things. Those are nice things to do to people that are in your neighborhood or that you may not know very closely, but you know they need some care and attention. So we need to know that other people than those that live in our house are our family. And that's what they're trying to tell us in today's readings. Okay, now let's move on to the profession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, the maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. And the Holy Spirit was incarnate in the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again in the third day with accordance to the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let's do the prayer for the faithful now. We have so much to be grateful for. Just as God loved and protected the Holy Family, God also cares for our families. So let's ask our loving God for all that we need to stay safe and happy. Our response to each petition will be, "Hear us, O Lord." For the Holy Father and all bishops and priests, they will care for the church the way Saint Joseph cared for his family. Let us pray to the Lord. Hear us, O family. For all the families of our parish, they will grow together in love and move forward in faith. Let us pray to the Lord. Hear us, O Lord. For all the families of our town, of our state, of the United States, of around the world, that they will be safe from harm and free from danger. Let us pray to the Lord. Hear us, O Lord. Now share with the people with you, your family members, something that you want your family to pray for. Okay, let's see. What do I have to pray for today? I would like us to pray for everyone to have a very healthy winter recess until they go back to school in January. Hear us, O Lord. Let us pray today that we will close with a very old prayer of protection. Usually it's said in the evening before you go to sleep, but since I won't see you then, let's do it now. Please repeat after me. Protect us, O Lord, while we are awake and while we sleep. Protect us, O Lord, while we are awake and asleep, that we may keep watch with Christ and rest in peace. That we may keep watch with Christ and rest in peace. Boys and girls, thank you so much for joining me today on this very special day to celebrate the Holy Family of Jesus, Mary, and Joseph. I hope everybody had a wonderful Christmas with the people in your house and that you celebrated the birth of Jesus. I wish you all a very, very Merry Christmas and continue to be safe and wear your masks. I look forward to seeing you before the spring, hopefully before Easter, but know that I'm thinking of each of you. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year to all of you. Bye, boys and girls. Hark the herald angels sing.